Thanks for joining me today. This video is the first in a series that will cover the implementation of Forcepoint's Web Security Cloud solution. This series will be presented from the perspective of a new account so that you can see all of the steps that are required to be able to get the solution up and running. We will cover logging into the cloud portal, configuration of the cloud setup wizard, and creating or editing admin accounts. If you have any questions during this video, feel free to leave them in the comments section below, and don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. Enjoy! Before we dive in, I would like to refer you to the resources that are available in the description of this video. Here you will find the Web Security Cloud Admin Guide, which should be your first go-to resource. You will also find the Web Security Cloud Getting Started Guide, which will help you get started. There will also be other key resources that I will mention throughout the video that you will be able to find below. If this is the first time that you will be logging into the Forcepoint Cloud Portal, which we will assume it is, you will need to locate your initial login credentials. If you recently purchased the Forcepoint Web Security Cloud solution, then you should have received an email from your Forcepoint account manager or Forcepoint's order processing team. This email includes the initial login credentials that you will use to log into the cloud portal. Let's take a moment to find these credentials. Once you have found these credentials, let's go ahead and navigate to the Forcepoint Cloud Portal. You should see the address on the screen now. Let's go ahead and use those credentials to log in. The first thing you should be presented with is the license agreement. This screen will show you how many users, the start and end date for your account, as well as an agreement in PDF format for you to download for your records. Once you have read through the license agreement, go ahead and hit the checkbox to accept it. After that, click the next button in the bottom right. This next section is the report data storage. This is where you can configure the cloud data centers your traffic will be stored in. We will pick a primary and secondary location for redundancy purposes. For more information on the Forcepoint Cloud Data Center locations, please refer to the article below titled Forcepoint Cloud Data Center Locations. Once you have selected the two data centers closest to you, let's proceed to the next screen. Here, you are asked for a password question for recovery purposes as well as an email address. The email address that you put here will be associated with the super admin of your cloud account. I would recommend putting in a group email address or an inbox that multiple people have access to in case the person associated with the email address leaves the organization. Once you have finished, let's go ahead and click Finish and then move on to the Cloud Setup Wizard. The Cloud Setup Wizard helps guide you through the initial setup of the Web Security Cloud solution. This wizard is completely optional and all of the configurations that we make through here can be done through the portal as well. So if you want to skip this, you can, but it can be helpful to some admins who are fresh to the solution. So let's get started. The first page here is the Firewall Setup page. This test is going to check to see if your firewall ports are open on port 80, 8081, and 8082. These are the primary ports that the Proxy Connect Endpoint Agent uses to download the pack file to your users' machines. This test might fail, which is okay, but you will need to work with your network team to get these ports open so that when you deploy the endpoint, in the future it is able to function correctly. Once you have run this test, let's go ahead and move on to the next page. Here, we will see the End Users page, which is where we will choose how we want to sync your users. When we sync your users' groups and email addresses, this will allow us to assign the policy against that user's group membership. What we can see here are the two options to sync your users. The first option here is the Enter Users Manually option, which isn't really a good use of your time because you have to manually input all the NTLM information of your users that you want to sync. We do have to input at least one user here manually to proceed to the next page, but later we'll use another tool to actually sync all of your users automatically. So with your time in mind, let's discuss the other option here, synchronize users from My Directory. This relies on a tool called the Directory Synchronization Client, or DirSync Client for short. The DirSync Client lives somewhere in your network and syncs your Active Directory users, groups, and email addresses with the cloud service. I typically install this on a domain controller in my lab environment, but you can install it on another server as long as it has access to your domain and is given the credentials that have access to the Active Directory. This is what we will install during this implementation series since it does require a bit of upfront configuration, but it will update the cloud automatically going into the future and it'll save you a bunch of time. So let's go ahead and add a user here for now. Here we will need to configure the user's name, email address, and NTLM identity. If you get an error when you add the user, then make sure that the user hasn't been synced before. If you are an existing customer migrating to the Web Security Cloud solution from the Web Security Hybrid solution, then you might have already synced your users in the past. If this is the case, then you will need to go through what is called a null sync, which tech support can assist you with. You can also refer to the article below titled Web Security Hybrid Null Sync. After we have added that user, we will move on to the policy setup. This is where we will configure which template is used for the default policy that will be created at the end of this setup wizard. Here we can see there are three different templates: default, security, and monitor only. The default will block categories such as adult material, productivity, and security. This policy is good for customers who would like to reduce the amount of time that their users spend on productivity loss sites and are focused on protecting their users from malicious files and websites on the internet. The security-only template will block categories such as extended protection, parked domain, and security. This policy is good for an organization who is less worried about users accessing productivity loss sites and is more focused on protecting their users from malicious files and websites on the internet. The monitor-only template should be straightforward. It is going to set all categories to allow and only log which sites the users are going to. Let's go ahead and select the security-only template for now, and remember, these configurations are available in the policy if we need to change them later. The last thing we'll do here is set the time zone for the account. Now that we selected a template and configured the time zone, let's go ahead and move on to configure the connections page. The connections page is where we will configure the egress IP address or network range that is associated with your office locations. This will help the cloud identify traffic that should be managed by the policy that we are creating. We will need to configure at least one connection, but you can configure more if you have them. From here, we will move on to the redirection page. This redirection page is another firewall test like the one we did earlier. This is going to test whether your firewall allows communication to the Forcepoint cloud over port 80, 8081, or 8082. If you haven't had time to work with your networking team yet, then we can skip this step and the next test step. From here, the only thing that we have left is to review the configuration that we've made and then finish the cloud setup wizard. Now that we have finished the cloud setup wizard, let's move on to creating and editing admin accounts for your cloud account. Here, we will navigate to the Account Settings Contacts page. On this page, you should see the account that you are logged into listed. Let's modify this account and change the password. To do this, you will need to select the username that is listed in the username column. On this next page, you will see the logon details that are available for this account. Here, you can update the username, email address, password, and permissions for the account. Once you have made the changes to the account, you can hit Save in the bottom left. To create a new account, we will want to navigate back to the Contacts page. We will want to click the Add button in the bottom left, and then input the relevant information about the user. Once you have filled this out and click the Submit, you will be on the Contact Details page where you can select the Click Here button to configure the username for this account. Once on this new page, you can configure the username, password, and permissions of the account. So let's take a moment to discuss the permissions that are available for each account. There are two types of permissions: account permissions and policy permissions. So let's break down the account permissions. The first option here is the Manage Users. This will allow the admin to view, create, edit, and remove or change permissions for other admin accounts. Next is the Directory Synchronization option. This allows the account to be used by the DIR sync client that I mentioned earlier, which is used to sync your AD with the Forcepoint cloud. This permission is not required for general admins and will only be used by the account that the DIR sync client will use. The next two options, View All Reports and View Data Security Reports, allow the admin to generate reports on user activity within the report catalog, report builder, and transaction viewer. The Managed Edge Devices option allows the admin to configure the edge devices that will connect with the Forcepoint cloud service. The edge devices is available under the Web, Network Devices, Device Management section. The Log Export option is what will be used for an account that is used with the Full Traffic Logging feature or the SIEM feature to send logs to your log aggregator service. The next four options are all policy permissions, which can be assigned to an admin on a per policy basis. The Modify Configuration option allows an admin to modify other admin accounts except for the logon of the other admin accounts. The View Configuration and View Configuration Audit Trail allow the admin to modify the configuration of policies and view what policy changes were made by other admins. The View Filtered Reports will only allow the admin to see the reports for the specific policy that they are assigned to. With an understanding of what each permission provides, you can now create accounts for other administrators to have access to your cloud portal. Thank you for watching this video where we were able to begin configuring the Forcepoint Web Security Cloud solution that will be used to protect your roaming users. In this video, we were able to log into the Forcepoint Cloud Portal, configure the Cloud Setup Wizard, and modify or create admin accounts. The next video of this implementation series will include a discussion about what deployment options are available within this solution. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below or reach out to your account manager for more assistance. If you would like to see more of these videos, feel free to hit that like button and subscribe to be alerted when more videos are posted. See you next time.